Woodchopping, I'd compare it to ballet. It is so intense. It's repetition, it's repetition. And it's just drilled into you. Time and time again, sweat, pain, anguish.
We're all sucking in the big ones.
There is grace. It's just not all about brute strength. It has to be accuracy and be precise. It's just so effortless and poetic. You have blisters, you have toes bleeding. With wood chopping, it's the same. We end up with toes being removed, axe in our legs. It is just sheer grit and determination. They're two totally different sports, but they are so common. Except the diet.
Welcome to the Sydney show. A beautiful day for wood chopping. Give it up for the semi-final, ladies and gentlemen. We
have okay, Timber, look, I have a relationship. If I find a piece, I like it, I hug it, I cut it down. G'day, name's Glenn Gillam, 34 years of age. Woodchopper here yet again at Sydney Royal Easter Show 2018. When it comes to woodchopping, we got the officials. We've got the ring stewards, the clean-up crew, the competitors. You've got the commentator.
I can't start till they finish the count.
That's okay.
For me, walking throughout the arena throughout the day, the diehard fans you see is the family members are there. Kids, Dagwood dog in their hand, sauce on their face. The old lady that's seen the buff blokes all their life that is still sitting there watching in the stands. You have the international people over here on holidays going, wow, we've never seen this in life before.
Yeah, you get your show fans, yeah. Some of them even follow you to the bar and check your beer or something like that, you know, because they just follow you all around the place, yeah. And my wife goes, oh, who are those people cheering for you? And I said, oh, they're my groupies, you know. Like,
what is the sharpest axe? You want to see it?
I'll go and grab one for you, eh? Everyone thinks they're not very sharp. They think, oh, if we hit our foot with it, it's not going to cut it. But it's very unforgiving if it does slip.
You think I'd use it to shave my beard off, wouldn't you?
That's just how Australia was built, with an axe and shovel and pick. You see the country, it's all about sheer grit and determination in life. You go to a city, you see a gym, you see shiny weights and mirrors. You go to the country, you see sweat, tears, dust. You just see passion.
Here's the whistle, we're all non-competitors. Please clear the ring, thanks.
My father chopped along with his 9 brothers. And there was 22 of us cousins and that chopped as well. So it's a big family thing. Yeah, he come from a family of 18.
It is a risky sport, it is dangerous. It's risky going up the tree. Some years ago here at Sydney, I put an axe in my leg and hey, I was off to hospital. 40 stitches later. It's just one of those things that happens.
Put 4 hits in and then I turned around the back. And as it hit the bark lifted the, skewed the axe. It came across that skewed axe side from going like that. Went sideways and severed my toe virtually right off. It was about an inch of skin that was only holding it on, yeah.
I took all 5 toes, scooped underneath and took all of them out. Luckily I had the good old Dunlop volleys on, didn't ruin an axe, and I just kept on going forward.
They're starting to bring in steel mesh socks now. So all the younger competitors now wear steel mesh braided socks, so that you can't cut your feet.
You could be cooking tea at home and slip with the knife. Oh, I lost part of my finger. No different here.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Victoria, Mr. Glenn Gillam!
Today we're going to have a medley. And at the end, there'll be a David Goliath battle. Austin Scribner, 15 years of age, wringing wet, probably 60 kilos.
How much do you think he weighs? 130, 40, maybe, I don't know. He's at least 3 times the size of me. I'm competing in the 2-board tree, and I'm up against world champion unhand standing block cutter, Glenn Gillam. My mum often says before I'm climbing a tree, just not to fall out, really. Can't fall off. if you hurt yourself. The reason if Glenn lost would be because he's worn out after climbing and chopping a block. The way I could beat him is by cutting my portholes right, saving the least amount of hits in my block on top and climbing very well.
I take my hat off to young Austin today to settle up beside me and have a go. Here at Sydney at a Stowe's, there's a certain power. When you look around and see the arena we've got, it's like you're a god back in the days with the amphitheatre. You've got a crowd cheering you on, and just to feel the pure vibrance and the roar of the crowd, from the person starting first to the person finishing last. Fierce the competition out there, and at the end of the day, sometimes all you have to do is blink and you go from first to last. But when you collect yourself and put it together and then deliver through the acts and just show the extension of your body and focus, it's just an incredible experience.
Yeah, we won. I'm rugged.
Congratulations, guys. Put our hands together, ladies and gentlemen.